before you press the return to home button. Understand how it works and these four tips to help you be successful as your drone is coming home, coming home.
Okay, all right.
And if you're new here, yo, I'm Christine Lozada, and this is Drone with CL. I love helping people to explore the world from the best view in the house, which is the sky with their drones. Tons of tutorials on this channel, so if that's something you're into, consider subscribing. Especially if you are newer to flying a drone, this is really important because too many people just press the button and assume that everything will work. And there's a couple of settings that will help you to be successful. Ooh, and I got actually, maybe not four tips, five. I have a bonus tip for you at the end around something that I always do to help me make sure I have the most successful landing. Let's start with how return to home works, because there's kind of two times it's happening. First is the bad time. Oh my gosh, where is my drone? I have no idea where my drone is. And you're pushing the button to have it come back to you, which I'll also share with you some info about maps. And so that is the first time, and the time that most people will use the return to home button. It's when they cannot locate their drone. The second time is when, oh, it does it for you. It's automatically kicking in return to home whether you want it to or not. And that's happening in two scenarios. One is you're getting low on battery, so it automatically kicks in return to home to come back to you before the battery dies. So in that instance, yes, you can cancel it out, but that's one of the times in which it will automatically do it for you. The second time is when you lose connection. In other words, your drone controller is no longer connected to your drone because there's interference, there's things going on. And when your drone is no longer connected after 11 seconds, boom, it will automatically kick in auto return to home. But in either of these settings, you've got to make sure that you've put the settings in there correctly. So let's talk about that in this next section. Which, by the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, cheers that like button, consider subscribing. And this is one of the questions I got in my drone Facebook group. Consider joining us over there. I like to answer a lot of your questions. All right, let's jump into this next part, which is around the settings. This first tip in the settings is simply making sure that before you blast your drone, you have full GPS connection and you're waiting for your friend to say those magical words, the home point has been set. You're waiting to hear that because it means your drone has picked up on GPS and you are ready to go. And so you can see on my controller that I look good, I have full connection, takeoff permitted, all the things. I am ready to go, but this is something that's really important because it leads into the next setting, which is around setting your home point correctly. So to set your home point correctly, I'm like underneath a tree right now, if you can see that. I'm about to launch my drone underneath a tree, and there's a reason why. And so I can show you how to update a new home point. And so I'm kind of gonna awkwardly launch my drone right now, and I'm gonna hold the left stick down just so it doesn't lift up into the tree. And I'm gonna fly it away from the tree, and I'm gonna go put it, somewhere clear. Over there in the parking lot or something. I am in the most random parking lot right now. This is not at all sexy. All right, so I've moved my drone over a bit, and now it's just on the other side. You can kind of see that on the screen right here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tap on the three dots, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to set a new home point. Underneath safety, I'm scrolling down to update home point. And what you're looking at here is three different things. One is me. I'm the blue dot. And just like Google Maps, this is just like Google Maps or Apple Maps. No one uses Apple Maps. You use Apple Maps, tell me in the comments below. Anyway, blue dot, the blue circle, that's me. The blue arrow, that's my drone. And you can even see which direction it's facing, right? So you can see it turning around, right? As I'm turning the drone around, that's the drone. And H is the home point. And don't forget, H is the home point where I have launched the drone, which is underneath this tree. And so to give you a little visual, if I were to actually land my drone with a return to home, what's going to happen is it's going to land. I'm gonna put X marks the spot so you can see it. It will land right here, which is where it came off from, which is into the tree. So what I want to do is I want to move the home point somewhere else. So going back into safety, I'm going to go into update home point. And you have these two options on the right. One is setting the home point as the drone right here. We don't really want that because the drone's above the tree. We can set the home point as the controller, but I am the controller and I'm underneath the tree. Or just like Google Maps, you can set it somewhere else. So see this, just like Google Maps, H for home point. So let's see, I'm over here. Let's just stick it in the middle of the parking lot, like over there, right? And now I'm gonna press okay. So I've moved the home point to somewhere else. And this might be important if you are at the beach, for example, and you don't want it to auto land on the sand and you want it to land in the parking lot, or if you're on a boat and you wanna put your home point as a dock nearby or the land nearby, not the water, which you might paddle or boat away from. And so I've updated this home point, which means now if I were to press the return to home button, it should go land over there. Let's do that. The return to home button on each controller is a little bit different. On this current controller I'm using, for this controller is both for the Mavic Air 2S that I have, the Mavic Air 2, and the Mavic Mini 3 Pro that I'm flying right now. But I'm simply going to press the H button, return to home. And oh man, I hate that sound. So you can see that I have the option to cancel return to home. And so what it's doing right now is it's flying over to the home area, which I had set toward the middle of the parking lot. And I can actually see that happening right now. Boom, look at you. Yay. Man, it's all the way over there. Yay! I could walk over there and get it. And voila, it's all the way over there. Let's talk about the next setting that's really important, and that's around your auto return to home height. And so to look at this, let's go back to the three dots. And one of the things under safety that you have under here is this one right here, which is auto return to home altitude. What this means is when you're flying your drone and auto return to home kicks in, then your drone will rise to this level, fly back to you, and then land where you had set your home point, right? What we just learned in that last tip. What's important to note here is a couple things. One, you might not want that auto return to home to be 400 in uncontrolled airspace if it's insanely windy outside. You just wanna make sure you are clearing enough things. So when I was flying in the Maldives, for example, an auto return to home of 65 is fine because the biggest thing I had to worry about was palm trees. This will look different in a city. I might be worried about buildings. So right now I just kind of leave it at 250 as my default setting. And one thing to note though is it depends, right? Do you have enough battery life for it to ascend that high and come over? And so this might be a setting you want to adjust before you go out and fly in case your auto return to home kicks in. The third tip is one that you already saw a little bit of, which was me getting away from this tree, right? And so updating your home point, even if it means just a couple feet or several feet away from you, so that you are in the clear, away from things, is super important, because how how sad would it be if I auto returned home into this tree and then I had a whole new set of problems to deal with, right? And so make sure you are completely clear, not just of things that it can hit like a tree, but also I don't really want it to auto return to home into the grass because I don't want that dirt potentially in the propellers or in the camera. On the cement is best, so I prefer it be over here. So choose your home point carefully. And maybe for this last tip, don't choose a home point at all and just catch it. So here's my last tip, and I think this one's really important because it will help you to become a much better drone pilot and drone operator, which is using return to home only when you really need it and using it enough to get it close to you and then finish the JOB yourself. So I've flown my drone out a little ways, and one thing to quickly do, and join me in my next video to learn the full tutorial on maps. I've just tapped on the bottom left onto maps, which so many people don't know it exists, and this is helping me to know which direction to look in for my drone, right? Because you can see my little dot is here, and so I know my drone is in that direction facing that way. And so given that I know that, I can look in the correct direction for my drone. My next step is I'm going to let auto return to home, or I'm gonna let return to home kick in by pressing the button. That sound just sucks, you know? I hate that sound. And so now, as it's coming closer to me, I'm going to look, and I know which direction to be looking in. I'm simultaneously looking up for my drone, I can see it, and I'm also looking at my controller to make sure I can see where we're at. And you can see that it raised up to the auto return to home altitude that I had. But here's another thing, right? The tree. Oh, the tree. Oh, look, 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 I'm about to hit that tree. So I'm gonna go ahead and cancel the return to home. Drone is right above me right now. I'm gonna move it over so that I can see it. And I'm just gonna finish the job myself, whether I hand catch it or whether I just land it on the ground. Come to mama. Bam. All right, let's recap what you learned today, because we did a whole lot of stuff with return to home. And it's really important you know how to use this before you actually use it, because generally you tend to be in kind of an emergency situation when you are pressing that button. And so the things that we learned is, one, how it works. There's those three points, right? Where you're setting your home point, choosing anywhere on the map, and understanding the difference between you, your drone, and your controller. The next thing we learned is when it's automatically done for us, and that happens when you have that low battery, or if your drone loses connection with the controller, then auto return to home is kicking in. Then we learned a few helpful tips. One is making sure you have great GPS and you have waited for that woman to say the magic words, which is your home point has been updated. All GPS signal has been picked up is what she means by that. And so then you're in the clear to be able to use that button. The next one is your settings around your auto return to home height. And depending on the situation you are flying in, you are set for a successful return of your drone. Next, we're making sure we are clear for landing, whether there's no trees around or you have a good space for it to land, potentially not on sand or grass, but somewhere that might be cleaner for your drone. And lastly, we're gonna do the job ourselves by potentially just using auto return to home to get it near us and then flying it back all the way ourselves to make sure we have a good landing. And I gave you that little bonus tip with the map. So if you want to learn more about maps, join me in my next tutorial. And also, all my info on my courses are in the show notes below. And also join us in the Drone Facebook group. It's a good time over there. See you in one of those places, maybe the next tutorial. All right, ciao.